Okay? So I will call the June 14th meeting of the East Village of East Dundee Planning and Zoning Commission to order. Do we have a roll call, please?
Scarpelli? Coleman? Meyer?
Here.
Epke?
Here.
Stenick?
Here.
Bernstein? Schaap?
Here.
Woskett?
Here.
Brewer?
Here. So that's quarter. Correct?
Yes.
Six. So first order is to approve the minutes from our last meeting, the Historic Commission regarding Diamond Jim's. Everybody have any comments, or would you just like to make a voice motion to approve these minutes? Would somebody do that?
Yeah, I'd like to make a motion to approve the minutes.
A second. All in favor?
Aye.
Ready against?
Flying through this now. Public comment on issues that are not related to the three items on our agenda tonight. Anybody else here? Okay, looks like everybody's here for the agenda items. So, new business. That's great. New business, I'd like to hear a motion to open the public hearing relating to the matter at 200 Christiana Drive to allow special use for a gun shop and indoor shooting range.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Ready against?
Okay, so we have village members who can do it, read the information as it relates to this.
So, first thing we're considering is the approval to have a special use permit for the gun shop and indoor shooting range. We have representatives here from Charlie. If you want to just talk to the board here and just let them know what your plans are.
What are you saying up here?
No, okay, so that's, yeah, now it's your presentation. That's basically enough for our, you know, the thing?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so yeah, let's have a petitioner's presentation.
Okay.
There you go. And I guess you need to, because this is a public hearing, we need to swear it with you, so.
Chair, okay, great.
Okay. So just identify yourselves, I guess, so we can tell who's doing what.
All right, I'm Ty Cobb, manager of Charlie Defense.
I'm Jonathan Inglis, I'm a range consultant.
And I'm Chris Kolschewski from WT Group. And just the building that we're talking about, the overall development, of course, is 50,000 square foot building down here from the corner. I apologize. Not visiting. So we have the speedway here, we go down Christina, and the 50,000 square foot building, which in turn, in the site plan, as you can see, is located right behind, right directly across from Joe's existing, just for orientation purposes. And then the other item shown on this side is
just. Excuse me, Chris?
Yes.
Can you pull it out more?
Certainly, certainly.
Just as a net case in point, this is a new building that is not existing.
Yes.
And it is on, when we have our lot 5 plan, which is in lot 3.
So it's one behind the gas station there?
Yes, yes. And this is the actual plan of the building itself. And then Trident will be taking a portion of that, roughly about 15,000 square feet or 50. It's still in negotiation, probably they need the area. So it'll be part of this building, and actually Trident is one of the two companies that really has helped secure the huge fund for EDT grant, almost $2 million for the whole improvement to the intersection, because it's stipulated on manufacturing, and so in terms of the lighting for the intersection at this corner here, and the roadway improvements, these are very key for that $2 million. And so that's basically where the business is at, and I'll let these gentlemen talk a little bit more about the business itself.
Questions so far? Okay, so we'd like to open up and move our current manufacturing and sales business, which is a niche market. 2 years ago when we sat in front of this board and obtained the special use permit, you know, we're just starting to get into some manufacturing at that point. Business is moving in the right direction. We'd like to expand on that. Mr. Palumbo has given us an opportunity to occupy part of the new building, and we'd like to do so with an advancement of a shooting range as well, and bringing that to the forefront, and essentially being the iconic shooting range in the Midwest is what we're aiming to develop, and bringing clients and customers from all over the area.
What type of weapons are you designing your range to use?
They will be capable and safe, up to high caliber rifles.
So you're talking 50 caliber snipers, sniper rifles, AK-47s.
They'll be capable of holding that type of ammunition. However, our range is only designed to be about 25 yards, so it's more apt for a pistol environment rather than rifle.
This will be just a 25 yard range?
Correct.
I guess I would have a question as far as the range. I assume it's all soundproofed and everything, so.
Brought the expert with me.
That's why I figured out. Kind of looked at when I asked the question.
Thank you for calling me in, John. I appreciate
that. Yep, I know.
So the Action Target's been doing shooting ranges for 30 years. We work with law enforcement, governments, military, all over the world. America being our primary business zone. But the range itself, as was mentioned, will be capable of stopping any civilian calibers, but what they shoot in there will be lower than the 50 cal, as stated. As far as the contamination, noise pollution, the ranges can be soundproof with a material called PET, polychlorous propylene. It has a noise reduction coefficient rating that meets the military standards. And then as far as the building design, and how they build those boxes out, that will further limit sound transmission to the outside area. What you can expect from most common shooting ranges is about ambient levels of noise. The traffic will be louder than the gunshots heard outside of the range if any noise is heard at all. The construction of the range. So there will be two styles of firing positions. One will be a fixed point from a stall that we're all probably familiar with. The other will be a tactical. And the baffle layouts for those two versions will keep all the rounds in the range and directed towards the bolt trap. And then as mentioned previously, they'll be class 2 rifle rated all across the board. So if somebody were to discharge a high caliber type of ammunition, it would be stopped and safely contained in that range space. The last portion of the range is the ventilation system. Action Target designs our ventilation systems to meet or exceed OSHA and NIOSH requirements. So the air moving past the firing line downrange will exceed the NIOSH regulations, and then OSHA and EPA will monitor inside and outside as far as what is exited from the range in relationship to the air. It will be cleaner than what is initially brought in. The HEPA filtration will capture 99.97% of all particulates, 0.3 microns or larger. So it is hospital grade air that will be exhausting back into the environment, not leaving any sort of adverse impact on the surrounding area. Any questions for me?
Yeah, could you take just a couple of seconds and explain the different classifications of weapons? You mentioned it's collector class 2 weapons.
So that's purely Action Target. So if you look through that blue book, you'll see class 1 and class 2. Class 1 is my way of denoting pistol rated materials, and class 2 is my way. Class 1 is pistol, class 2 is rifle. And we do that because of UL listings. Most commonly, in ranges of the past, UL listings would be UL level 5, which is sufficient to stop a 308 caliber round. 223s do a little bit more damage than a 308, so UL 7 is where you would want to start that. But getting into all those numbers got confusing, So we just made it simple, UL, or class one is pistol stopping, class two is all back covers.
Just from my own knowledge, where can I, where do I research that?
Yeah, you can Google UL listings.
UL listings.
UL listings for bullet calibers, yeah.
Okay.
And then if you go through, I can show you the page, I can approach in this book. It's most broken down when you're looking through the salt. So right here are all common pistol and rifle ammunitions. And then here is our glass and salt, you know, where we're talking about the class one and class two. And it's giving the velocities, which is where the UL listings are based on, energy as well. And then these will break down the individual, you know, typical velocities and energies. So I'll save you the Google research. It's all right there.
Okay, thanks.
Yes, sir.
Is this facility going to be a multi-tenant setup or just strictly just the range?
No, it's designed, we're going to share the entire building. We're only going to occupy roughly 14,000 square feet.
14 of the 50?
Correct. We will be the end unit closest to Christina Drive.
Any other questions or comments or anything?
So the building in the picture at the far back of the picture, that's the building that's going to house the range?
And the building itself.
The range is going to be along the length of the building then, right?
No, the depth.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So it's only a 25-yard range. Through years of research, we've realized that any indoor range that's substantially longer doesn't necessarily generate the same type of revenue that a shorter range would. So we've opted to go with a shorter range, and therefore we've also brought in more of a newer style product.
And how many stalls are going to be in there for?
We're going to have three indoor ranges essentially. So, you know, the inside is going to be broken into three areas. We'll have a members range, we'll have a tactical range, and then what we're going to have is a public lane style shooting range. There'll be six stalls open to the public on range A. We will have stalls in range B. However, that's going to be set up for tactical throughout the week. And then in range C, it's going to be an open forward platform. We will have two target retrieval systems / shooting stalls in that particular range.
Just one final comment I'd like to make on my presentation in your staff report is all the four elements, the standards that need to be met for the special use, and I think the staff puts it very well. The building, you know, is offset and back screened and amongst industrial, so you'll have the positive aspects there, not any injurious actions on any surrounding property. It will not impede any of the normal developments that's going to occur A, in front of it or behind it. So that will, I mean, these buildings are already going in for permit and slated for construction September for both Speedway and for James Building. So construction of new buildings is already occurring there. The third element is the adequate utilities, which are the sanitary waters. So that's already been brought up and in place. This is basically a pad-ready site. And then the fourth measure is adequate measures we take and provide ingress and egress, and that will occur, of course, off of Christina. And basically, we'll have the two curb cuts right here. We do have one off of Nina as well, so more than adequate. So there will not be backing up with traffic on the road or pushing it. So I believe we meet all four of the standards that are required for special use.
Just a question for Tyler. So his, I mean, is the police department, do they have any comments, issues on this? Do they have the right to have any comments or issues on this?
Yeah, they're on comments.
Okay, fine. Four things that in these, the excellent job as usual that the staff does, Brad, Chris, and Tyler, and just pass it by you guys. Four items, we issued a special use will expire when you vacate this building. That's clear, right?
Absolutely.
Security plan, ensuring the stock is locked and secured in a secure space with burglar alarms and everything else. That was, it's not going to be different than the special use we gave you already, but I just want to make sure we're all on the same page with that.
Correct.
Firearm sales and purchases must be recorded and available to the chief of police. Again, that's part of your other location, you put that in there too. And the only other one was the operation as a gun shop shall be accessory use for the firearm coding service. So basically, you maintain all three of those businesses in this accessory.
Correct.
Moving back to shooting range and the coding service.
Correct. Moving our current operation, right, manufacturing and gun sales,
right,
to the new facility with addition to the range.
Okay, so all of those, because we'll probably put that on as, those four items will probably go on with the findings. Okay? Anybody else have any questions or comments or anything?
Special use will apply to the whole building. Should they decide to expand, they can expand within the facility as long as Volvo has available space.
Yes.
Okay.
So the only guy I expect for the rest of it. I don't think that we need to, if you read the memo from the team here, I think it answers most of the questions that would be on the finding of facts, which would be turned to put over to the absolute last page. I think those are clearly, pretty well answered to the affirmative on all of them. So, I guess we proceed from here. We close the public hearing right now. So, do you have a motion for that?
So,
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
No further discussion. Can I hear a motion to approve the finding of, we have to do motions?
We have to.
We have to approve the special use request and include those items 1 through 4 on the, June 14th, November. So, 1 through 4 is including the, I guess they are just special conditions.
I'll make a motion. We approve the special use permit for 03-25-126-004, permit gun shop and indoor shooting range, with all the comments of the Village of East Dundee memorandum, subject 200 Christina Drive special use, dated June 14th, 2018.
Yes.
Scarpelli?
Yes.
Meyer?
Yes.
Apke?
Yes.
Stenick?
Yes.
Schott?
Yes.
Musket?
Yes.
Brewer?
Yes. One more. I have a motion to approve the finding of fact for the special use, again for the same location, 200 Christiana Drive, East Dundee, based on the, again, the presentation from staff. Looks like everything will be in the affirmative on this.
I'll make a motion to approve the finding of fact as presented by Village of East Dundee's finding of fact special use, 200 Christiana Drive, East Dundee, Illinois, dated June 14th, 2018.
Second that.
Scarpelli?
Yes.
Meyer?
Yes.
Apke?
Yes.
Stenick?
Yes.
Schott?
Yes.
Musket?
Yes.
Brewer?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Get the building moving. Let me change my paper. Let's get right on to the second one, second public hearing. Again, lot tied to a business park. To consider request of variation from section 57.1 to 3, parentheses C, and 59.049, parentheses C, of the subdivision chapter for East Dundee requiring parkway trees. So, get a motion to open that public hearing?
I'll make a motion to open the public hearing for lot 5, Kara Business Park.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any against?
You want to read it?
So this is regarding lot 5, so lot 5, I guess you don't want to go for this, but lot 5 is entire, lot 2 and 3 together. What you're going to be discussing here is a waiver of the park tree requirement that requires it for village code that parkway trees are spaced every 40 to 60 feet. There's also a requirement for interior trees.
About 30 feet?
So there, with the parkway tree and interior tree requirements, there's a duplication of trees there. So village staff is recommending with them for the commission to approve this variance for the parkway tree aspect of this.
So just a quick question. We're looking at a plat of lot 5. Can we see lot 1, lot 2, lot 3, and lot 4? Where does this apply?
In my opinion, it would apply to all of lot 5 going forward.
The whole, this whole thing applies.
Is that correct, Joe?
Mm-hmm.
So future reference, if they really subdivide in the future, we're not going to go through this again.
Right.
And remove the parkway trees on every lot. Is that correct, Joe?
That's correct.
Perfect. Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
And Chris Kalashevsky from WT Group. We have Joe Palomo. This is a very crude exhibit, and it says these green dots are representing trees. So what we're trying to clearly state is that we're not asking to make this barren. All we're trying to do is on the parkway, as you can see here, this is a property line and it's a curb line. If you had additional trees every 40 feet in there, the trees would literally be growing together, and eventually one or two of them, just because of the property. And so we're just asking for a practical. The hardship is the distance from the roadway to the property line, and then the required amount of interior trees. So you can see we have plenty of trees. We're just asking for that variance. Again, it's the same situation. In this case, we actually have 9 items that need to be shown to get approved for the variance. Really, again, your staff report clearly defines that. I'm just going to give some highlights rather than just reading the report itself. Reasonable rate of return, you know, just adding additional trees, it's just going to, if that are actually going to kill one another, just does not make common sense for putting use of funds in that manner. Unique circumstances, item 2. Again, in terms of the distance of the roadway, the parkway. And the variation of granted will not essentially alter the character of the neighborhood. As you can see, there will still be the vegetation. We're talking this area right here, specifically this exhibit is demonstrating this. So we've got the character of the bigger building, so a big building here. Probably planning on another one in the future here. So it will be in harmony with the essential character of the neighborhood. If there are any other questions about any of the other findings of that, I'm happy to go over them point by point. But I'm basically saying this is really a common sense kind of shape that we're asking for to be alleviated so you don't have duplicity and quite frankly, trees fighting for privacy.
So all the trees will be on private property, so the village won't have to maintain any trees.
Okay.
Does the village code
if, I'm seeing it's a private property, if they treat guys, does the landowner have a obligation to replace the tree?
Yes.
Okay. Does it ever happen?
What's the time, what's the count on the tree that's got to go?
Two or three.
Two, it depends on the species.
Two, three.
And another point is that the village has utilities in that parkway, so it would be very difficult to repair utilities when we've got trees there. The parkway is abnormally narrow because commercial industrial park, we normally require 80-foot right of way, and this is 66-foot.
Any other questions on this one? Okay, well, I'll move. Somebody be able to close the public hearing, please? Is there any public comment on this one?
I'll make a motion to close the public hearing.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any against?
Okay, can I hear a motion to approve this? Variance on for lot five of Terra Business Park to approve the variation regarding the tree.
I'll make a motion, we approve, recommend the variance for 03-25-126-004 from section 57.123C and 159.049C of the subdivision of chapter of East Dundee Village Code for lot five of the Terra Business Park.
Scarpelli?
Yes.
Meyer?
Yes.
Gapke?
Yes.
Danny?
Yes.
Schaaf?
Yes.
Musket?
Yes.
Zerler?
Yes. Okay, finding the facts, anybody have any comments on those? Again, I believe in reading the staff memorandum, they're all covered. It was also covered by the presentation. Thank you. And obviously it looks to be the affirmative or no particular conditions involved. So can I have a motion to approve the findings of facts for this variance?
Second.
Scarpelli?
Yes.
Meyer?
Yes.
Gapke?
Yes.
Stenick?
Yes.
Schaaf? Musket? Yes. Zerler?
Yes. Very good so far. Okay, can I hear a motion to open our third public hearing regarding lot two of the Terra Business Park to consider a variation regarding building setbacks?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any against?
Comments?
Yeah, so this one is regarding lot two, which can be the retail center. They need a variance. The current setback is at 40 feet required. They're asking for a front yard setback of 22 feet. This is on Patricia Lane, which is the interior road of the development here, which is actually the side of the actual retail center. So it's staff's recommendation, given that it's the size of the building and the interior road, that the commission approved this variance. If you have additional comments.
Yes.
So the setback off 72 is standard, just on the side.
Yes, just the side. Yeah.
Do all the other setbacks are met, even coming in on the Christina. It's just this short one here. Again, we're side to side with whatever future building will be here. The presentation is towards 72. The building is made up of 10 20-foot units. If we technically would be to meet the 40-foot, we would lose an entire building, which would also be a reduction of a tax impact for the village as well. And so it's literally just along this strip and along this strip. But we want to make clear that there's still a lot of green area between the two. It isn't pavement. So it's a pavement. and then drive to the bypass lane and then the building itself, which is in 20 feet. Again, for this one, you need to meet all lining categories, and again, I believe we need that in terms of the particular hardship is that we have a set dimension from Christina to this property line, and we've added this road that's going to help the whole development. And so the road is actually impinging on the developable area, and so somewhere at 20 feet, I'm not quite sure, we have 22, the setback would be 40, so the 18 feet is what we're asking variance for. And so with that, this will not only benefit us, but development behind us, Joe's building and anything going further, and also will be a feeder to the east for future retail development.
Is your photo there fairly accurate, the rendering?
Yes.
So the 22 feet of private property is going to be pretty much the two driveways, correct?
Well, this, our property line, actually what we have is, this is already part of the 22 feet, this is the 22 feet, the grass is 22 feet.
Oh, the grass, oh, okay, so then, so the pavement is the, okay, considered the, okay.
And the function of the pavement, the function is the drive through for one lane, and then emergency bypass, that's required.
So the village right of way is all pavement on your side?
No. There's a green parkway in that village. So the drive through lane is the front line.
So the green is the village on the, what would that be, the west side of that?
Yes.
So then the 22 feet is your two drive lanes, the building.
Okay.
So I guess the only comment I would have is, since with the previous variance, we just waived the need for any trees in the parkway, in order to put trees on that side, it would have to be in the parkway. So as part of this variance, can we require that they put trees in that parkway? Even though we just gave the variance.
Services.
I guess we wouldn't have any trees on the side of that building.
No.
No.
Okay.
It's not considered interior yard because it's a drive through lane. You're not allowed to park in the interior, but
right
on that lane.
So drive through. Okay.
And that's a right, ends right out. Right. The street there.
Entrance.
Yeah,
the church right there.
Patricia Lane is then, yeah.
Oh, on to 72.
On to 72.
It's actually a three-quarter intersection. It does not allow left outs, but it'll allow left in, a right in, and a right out.
Okay. All right. And I assume it'll be signed up so we can run it. If you want to go east on 72, you have to drive across.
Correct. You have to go to, you have a couple options, but you'll have to get to Christina.
Yeah.
At the left.
Any other questions? Well, can I hear a motion to close the public hearing? Howard, do you want to close the public hearing?
That's just my normal one.
Well, okay.
Always dated.
Okay.
I'll make a motion we close the public hearing.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any against?
Okay, I hear a motion to approve this requested variance for the setback on lot two in the lot two of lot five in the Zero Business Park.
It would not be a middle thing, but
to use the loan.
That's fine. Okay, we did, you did not go through the whole items, all of my items. I didn't see anything related with any of the staff related problems with any of those, so. Again, could I hear a motion to approve the findings of facts for this variation?
So moved.
All of the positive?
Second. Scarpelli?
Yes.
Meyer?
Yes.
Apke?
Yes.
Bennett?
Yes.
Schott?
Yes.
Musket?
Yes.
Brewer?
Yes. I'm sorry, did I ever close that public hearing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Anybody have, you should have any questions, anybody? I hear a motion to adjourn.
I do have one, it's still up for one, thank you.
Is it good? Can we do that?
Oh, did you get?
That was the minute, oh, we just approved the minutes of our. Just as I passed, I said the last.
John, I have one thing.
Yes.
Just wanted to gauge feedback from all of you. So we meet here on the second Thursday of each month. After items are discussed and approved with the ninth year, we then have more of the time to bring it to the village board. And for this, take tonight's meeting, next book board meeting on Monday. We had to prepare items by tomorrow for that meeting. In order to give staff a little more time to be able to get these items on the next board meeting, our thought is to move this meeting either the first Thursday or the third Thursday. Or, yeah, third Thursday. Because that would then give us a week to prepare items for the board. Otherwise, it could potentially be, a month. I mean, depending on when the board meeting, if there's, and we don't want to delay any requests from our project moving forward, so. I know a few of you are missing tonight, so we have to gauge their feedback as well, but is there any progress between moving it to a first or third Thursday?
My preference is first.
First.
Do you want the first and final two?
I just want to make sure we get these items to the board.
The only issue we had was we tried to.
As long as you don't do this like in the next 2 weeks, we're okay.
No, I think we have to bring it to the board, and I think get the official meetings that will change, so.
I think we had prior discussion about trying to do it earlier, too, with that, because we had people just can't get here.
Get here at like 6:00.
Somebody said, why did you do it before the board meeting? And sometimes you have to do it all.
Yes.
This is how you make it for us.
Yeah.
Because we didn't have.
So, yeah, if we could, we'll look at what the gauge is, from the other side here, but we'll have to move it to the first step.
Well, for the two that we have a year.
But again, you're saying, are you thinking next month?
Next month, I don't know that we have enough time to get.
That's where I'm going.
So I'm thinking of the August, if we have any, probably the first one.
Let us know.
We'll do it. Thank you.
Anything else? Trailer? I'm sorry, the annex, like the 24th, the 25th, maybe?
25th is supposed to move.
We do that.
No, we didn't adjourn yet.
I thought we.
Thank you, staff.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry, I have a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.